Hello everyone, welcome back to edupediaword.com. In this video, we will be learning the topic ogive for the given data. Friends, some pronounce this word as ogive also, but we will be using the former pronunciation. So in this video, we will be learning about the types of ogive and their graphical plots with the help of an example. So first of all, why ogive? What is its significance? Friends, ogive is used to represent the cumulative frequency distribution graphically, and by that graph we can calculate the median for the given data. That is, ogive can simply be used to calculate the median for the given data. Now this is how ogive in general will look like. That is, on y-axis we will be having cumulative frequencies, whereas on x-axis we can either have upper limits or lower limits of the given class intervals of the given data. Now we have two types of ogive. For the less than type ogive, the cumulative frequency versus upper limits of the class intervals of the given data are drawn in a graph, whereas for more than ogive, it is a graph of cumulative frequency versus the lower limits of the class intervals of the given data. Now let us have an example to plot the two type of ogives. Here, number of matches with the corresponding runs scored by a batsman are tabulated. Let us first talk about the less than type ogive. Friends, since cumulative frequencies are involved, so first of all we can calculate the cumulative frequencies for the given table as calculated here. Now clearly, what are cumulative frequencies? The first frequency is written as it is, and then for the second row these two frequencies are added, for the third row these three frequencies are added, or simply add the preceding cumulative frequency with the current frequency, that is 28 plus 10 38, 38 plus 8 46, and so on. Friends, the first cumulative frequency, that is 15, include the class interval 0 to 10, whereas the second cumulative frequency include the class interval either 0 to 10 or 10 to 20. Why? Because this 18 is the sum of this frequency plus this frequency. So both of these class intervals are included. Now, friends, in this tabulated form of class intervals, we have made a convention that the lower limits will include the values represented by them. That is, suppose we need to locate for 10, then the 10 will be included in this class interval because its lower limit is 10, and not this interval because its upper limit is 10. So in this class interval 0 is included, whereas 10 is not, which is included in this interval. Similarly, let us pick another interval 50 to 60 randomly. So here 50 is included, whereas 60 is included here because its lower limit is 60. So we can write these two class intervals simply as below 20. So below 20 we have 18 number of matches. So we can here make another class interval or the table as below 20 Now for these three frequencies, they include all these three class intervals, that is 0 to 10 or 10 to 20 or 20 to 30. So we can simply write this class intervals in one line as below 30 or less than 30. That is, for less than 30 runs we have 28 matches. Similarly, for this row we can write that less than 40 we have 38 matches, because all these four frequencies are included, and less than 50 we have 46 matches, less than 60 we have 51 matches, and so on. That is, write the upper limits corresponding to the given cumulative frequency prefixed with less than. Therefore, for last term it will be less than 100, and for the first term it will be less than 10. So a clear tabulated form of the given table is shown here. The runs code in one column and the corresponding cumulative frequencies in the other column. Now we can plot these two columns in a graph by using the x-axis for these upper limits, that is 10, 20, 30, 40 and so on, and the y-axis for this cumulative frequency. So here it is the graph plotted. This type of graph where the x-axis are represented by upper limits corresponding to the cumulative frequency, which are represented on y-axis, we get a less than ogive. Now clearly, for the first column the upper limit is 10 and the corresponding cumulative frequency is 15. So 10 and 15 is this point. For the second point we have 20 as x coordinate and 18 as y coordinate. So we have here 20 and 18. So this type of ogive, dear friends, is less than ogive. So once we have plotted this less than ogive, we can utilize this ogive for calculating the total number of matches corresponding to the given less than digit or figure. Say suppose we need to calculate the total number of matches in which the runs code are less than 34. So locate 34 here on x-axis, draw a perpendicular on this curve, and then locate the corresponding point on this y-axis, that is this particular point, which will be around 33 or slightly less than 33. So an approximate total number of matches will be 33, in which the runs code are less than 34. Now let us talk about more than ogive. Again, consider the same example. Now we need to modify this class interval in more than type form to get the more than ogive and the corresponding graph. Friends, earlier we have used upper limits for less than ogive. Now for more than ogive, we will be using lower limits. Now we will be tabulating this given question in more than type form using the lower limits. That is, suppose वी नीड टू नो द नंबर ऑफ मैचेस इन विच रन स्कोर्ड आर मोर देन जीरो. Clearly, a digit between 10 to 20 is greater than 0. A digit between 20 to 30 is also greater than 0. So, this is true for all the cases. In fact, a number between 0 to 10 is also greater than 0. But, our convention says that lower limits are including the digits represented by them. That is, in this interval we are also having the matches in which the run scored are 0. So we cannot simply calculate all the matches in which run scored are more than 0, but we need to prefix certain more words as more than or equal to 0 on account of our convention. So in all the matches the run scored are more than 0 and the total matches are 100. So the corresponding number of matches are 100. Now let us utilize the second lower limit, that is more than or equal to 10 and the corresponding number of matches. All these class intervals will contain the number more than or equal to 10, but not this class. It will contain the number less than 10. So, from all the 100 matches, we need to subtract this interval. That is 100 minus 15 or 85. Now, the third lower limit is 20. So, more than or equal to 20, no doubt we need to subtract this 15 from the total, but also this 3, because a number between 10 to 20 is less than 20. Now, after subtracting this 15 from the total, we have got 85. Now, further subtract 3 from that 85. And we get 82 as the total number of matches in which runs scored are more than or equal to 20. Similarly, for 30, we need to further subtract this 10 because a number between 20 to 30 is less than 30. So, subtract 10 from this 82 and we get 72. On calculating till last, we will get the last lower limit as more than or equal to 90. Now, more than or equal to 90 are only 3 matches. So, here the last cumulative frequency will be 3. We can easily conclude that this cumulative frequency is a decreasing type frequency or a decreasing type cumulative frequency. So, a clear table of the corresponding cumulative frequency and the runs scored are shown here. Now, if we plot these lower limits and the cumulative frequency on a graph, we will get a more than type ogive. So, here we have the table that we have just calculated, and the plot of this table will give us the more than type ogive. Now, similar to the less than type ogive, suppose if you need to calculate the number of matches in which run scored are more than a particular value, say more than 10 or 11 or 12, you just locate say 12 over here, make a perpendicular on this curve and get the corresponding value on the y-axis, which will be the required number of matches in which the runs scored are more than 12. So friends, that's all on ogive. Thanks friends for watching this video.